my favorite characters are the ones that are, or the, at least the characters that I grew up with, you know, are, were people that had a little bit of both. Mm-hmm. So it just feels more natural to me.
Not anymore.
I mean, I guess, look, I'm going to direct a movie in April, so mm-hmm. I feel like that's all I can really think about right now. Well, it's not like I'm trying to be secretive. I just think it's like I'm a little superstitious.
Yeah?
I feel like it's bad luck.
Like a baby, you don't want to talk about it until it's 3 months.
Exactly. In this case, it was like a unique situation because you have like a story that's real, and you have real people that these characters are based on, and yet these are fictionalized events and fictionalized versions of these people. So mm-hmm. trying to find a balance between the two. And he like had a very academic approach to the historical content of the film, but then he at the same time was like totally turning it on its ear and making this very fantasy version of the truth. And I think those two things come together in an interesting way to put his own stamp on.
And Cop, it's not for sale. It's like a dog with rabies. You just gotta put him down.
Don't go.
Don't let me.
Los Angeles is my destiny.
Is that right?
Gallo! 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 Gallo!
You will find out!
Begging for a bullet before it's over.
Like a dog!